And now, the mythology of time. It is said that time was created from a single, silent teardrop from the most beautiful woman on earth, Helen of Troy. The Romans associated time with their goddess of love, Venus. And why not? I mean, just look at that sexy little herb. Yeah, baby, you still got it. Now, it was also considered a symbol of sacrifice and courage to the ancient Greeks, and it was often burnt in sacred temples as an offering to the gods or protection against evil. Time was also considered a very big aid for those making their passage into the next life. And this is because it was believed that the souls of the deceased actually took up residence in the flowers of the time plant. So, people would place it either in or on top of coffins to ensure safe passage into the afterlife. In Wales, England, they didn't just believe that it was the souls of the dead. Oh no, they believed it was the souls of people who had been murdered. Is there something that the Welsh know that they're not telling us? Still alive and need a good night's sleep? Well, the Scottish Highlanders of old would prepare a tea of wild thyme for vigor and to ward off those nasty nightmares. It was also said that if you placed thyme beneath your pillow at night, it would fend off nightmares and demons. Or it would just let you get a nice good night's sleep because your sister is snoring and she won't let you drift off peacefully. Stop it, sis! Stop it! Just let me sleep! Let me sleep! Over in Jerusalem, there is a legend that thyme was included in a special little manger where this gal named Mary gave birth to a kid named, what was it again? Jesus. Having love problems, my friend? Well, thyme eaten on the evening of St. Agnes is said to help cure love sickness. After you ate it, you were supposed to say the phrase, St. Agnes, that's to lovers kind. Come, ease the troubles of my mind. And after that, whoosh! Watch your lovesick troubles flow away. But that is nothing compared to the crazy tradition that happens on the eve of St. Luke's Day. English women would make a mixture that included thyme, marigold, wormwood, and a sprig of marjoram. Then rub it all over their stomachs, breasts, and lips. Then, while lying down, you're supposed to repeat the phrase, St. Luke, St. Luke, be kind to me. In dreams, let me my true love see. After you've said this, hasten off to bed, because in your dreams, you will see a vision of your true love. Apparently, you could also use thyme for love divination in other ways, too. If you place the name of your prospective lovers under different pots of thyme, the one that grows the fastest and strongest is the name of the person who should become your sugar dumpling. And this brings me to one of the best myths about thyme. It attracts fairies. Fairies are said to love thyme. In both England and France, people would create a bed of thyme to attract fairies to make them feel more at home in their gardens. In fact, it was believed that a bed of thyme is where fairies like to take up residence. So people would set aside a special patch of thyme in their gardens that they wouldn't touch. Kind of like an herbal fairy house. In literature, thyme is also very famously associated with fairies. See if you remember this one. I know a bank where the wild thyme blows, where ox lips and the nodding violet grows, quite over canopied with luscious woodbine, with sweet musk roses, and with eglantine. Know it? Good for you. It is indeed from a speech by Oberon in Shakespeare's A Midsummer Night's Dream. And I bring this up not just because it's the location of where Titania, Queen of the Fairies, is found, but rather because the English used thyme in a recipe in the 17th century that helped you see fairies. You think only the English did this? Wrong! Both Danish and German folklore list patches of wild thyme as the best place to find fairies. Over there, thyme oil was supposed to help you see fairies, but only if it was gathered near the side of a hill where fairies live. But apparently, things fell apart for thyme somewhere in the 1800s. As bringing wild thyme into a British household was considered such bad luck that it could cause serious illness or even death. Which is really weird, because I found nothing that said thyme was bad luck until the 1800s. However, they only believed this about wild thyme and not common thyme. Also weird. Let's finish things up with a little bit of witchcraft, shall we? Witches have a bevy of really cool ways that thyme can be used to help you out. Wanna ease your grief? Then hang some thyme to air out in your home. Needing to let go of things? Then put thyme in a box with the symbols of the things that you want to let go. Then, when you feel ready, burn that sucker! And scatter the ashes over a body of water. Did you lose your keys? Or maybe your phone again? You know, it's the fairies that might actually be responsible. Hey, don't worry. They're happy to bring them back. On the night of a full moon, leave an offering of fresh thyme and honey in the woods, with a note asking for some help to get your lost item back. Just make sure you don't run into any werewolves. Is your wallet looking thin? Then you better make sure you plant some thyme in your garden. And at the beginning of a waxing moon, place several coins or even some paper currency in with a root ball and bury it near a sunny spot in your yard. Watch it grow, along with all of your investments. And, you know, if that fails for some reason, you got a couple of bucks hidden away to fall back on. Thanks so much for watching. As always, if you liked the video, hit the like button, share, subscribe. If you're interested in more herbal mythology, then go ahead and click on the Mythology of Basil. My question for today is, have you ever heard any of these myths before? Maybe you've tried them? If so, hey, let me know in the comment section below how they went. Until next time, be kind to each other, and make sure you save a little bit of thyme for the fairies.